older stuff before my husband and I started doing music together, so this is my just me stuff. But I appreciate you guys letting me share with you tonight. And thank you so much for my dad and my sister surprising me. I thought I was alone. This is big for me, super big. And I come from Fairfield, so traveling here and all that, like, this is a big step. So thank you all for being a part of my journey. This is for my friends and family.
Where I am in this struggle, in the mind.
Now I don't know if Terry was up for me to do one more. I do have one more. If not, we're good. We're good. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you. Jennifer, you have one like that. Thirdly, I don't really know how to do it.
Yeah.
What? She can rap. See me later. I want to sign you.
All right.
Okay, amazing job. With no further ado again, at this time we're going to present to the stage Mr. Terry Moore, and he'll be presenting our male panel. Let's put our hands together for Terry Moore.
All right, how's everybody doing? All right, let me get my gentleman up here. Let's get up here quick. We have more speaking time. The quicker you get up here. Duchess Battle here. Duchess not here. Okay, so put your hands together for my gentleman. Come on up here. It's hard to get gentlemen to come up here today and speak. So we applaud these guys. We got everybody up here. So I'm going to start introducing now. So I'm just going to say a little bit about you, but I want you to say just a little bit. The less time we take on introductions, the more time we get to speak. Remember that. All right. All right, we're going to start right here with T.D. Trice. He's a big-time director over at Access Sacramento. Is there anything else you want to say? T.D. is also a singer.
Hello. Is it me you're looking for? All right, now. Are we talking about?
Introductions really quick. I'm going to say your name, and you just say your name, and thank you, whatever. Praise God, and just let me move you forward.
Hey man, whatever. Thank, praise God, and you know, whatever.
TV Tri singer. We got Alec Poe, he's the big brother at the Daddy's Here program at the Center for Father Families. Anything else you want to say?
Happy to be here. And
all right, thank you. We got Mel Knox. He is a former Mr. Black Sacramento. And anything else you want to say?
Well, Terry, yes, I do.
It's gonna be quick, right?
Very quick. I am a man who is married. I've been married for 3 years now. I have 2 children. I just had a second baby girl who is 4.5 months.
All right. Cardell, he's also a part of the Center for Positive Families. Really great guy. He's a singer too. What do you think I'm going to say?
I'm not a singer. I'm happy to be here. Let's have some fun.
All right, Mr. Steve Fitter, he is an activist. This man works with youth and he does a lot. He works with Greg King. Anything else you want to say?
Nothing. Thank you for coming.
All right, thank you. All right, we got Chef Pennell. It's obvious. He's a chef, so anything else you want to say?
Anybody hungry?
Everybody hungry? All right. We got Jerry Goff. Jerry Simpson, he also goes by Goss. Famous artist. He's Nordstrom's artist, and he owns his own shop, his own gallery. Anything else you want to say? All right, right on. We're doing this good. All right, we got Montario Thompson. He is the current Mr. Black Sacramento runner-up. Anything else you want to say? All right, my name is Terry Moore, and we're gonna go on with our thing. So, what we're talking about is the differences between women and men. The differences between men and men. So, we'll start this in. The difference between women and men and women.
I'll start off by saying, it's going to be the upbringing of every individual's background and how they're raised in the environment. Some people are brought up in places where love is not even used or even a word to them, or grown up into single households. So that can affect them long term, for one. And for two, we have to look at the change in time. You know, people that were born in what, the 40s, 50s, 60s, that have been married for centuries, and we're looking at people now, and relationships seems to be the elephant in the room. So we just need to understand that the time and age and the difference between every individual can play a key role in using the word love or relationship.
How's everybody doing? I'm a man that's been married for 30 years. I've been with my wife 35 years. I have 6 kids and 10 grandkids. And I've been around. So what I feel is the difference between men and women is the fact that patience is important. A man needs to be there because he has the patience. When they're in a hurry, they want everything fast. It's like a fast food restaurant. Give it to me now, give it to me now, give it to me now. Even if it's going to make a mistake down the road, just give it to me now. So sometimes you have to have a man in your house that can say, stop, hold on for a minute, wait a minute, or go to the bathroom, do whatever you need to do just so that you can calm down for a minute. And then come back. Every relationship needs a man that can just say, sit down.
Good evening. Gentlemen, I have not had enough experience with enough women to assess what the difference is between man and woman, for the simple fact that every woman has her own self, and every man has his own self. We have similarities. Now that we've had these crossovers, if you will, men want to be women and women want to be men. Hey, who knows? So your guess is as good as mine what the difference is. All it can go by experience. And I'll tell you about that later.
Okay, I just want y'all to know every time I get a microphone, I like have flashbacks. So if I jump down and start doing James Brown and shit like that, y'all understand. It's like, hey, it's my turn. Okay, I'm up. Me personally, I have to really just examine myself, and I really think that the most important thing in a relationship in terms of men and women and the differences is that I think men have been socialized to really only use one emotion. There's only one socially acceptable emotion, and that's anger. And for me personally, I hope I woke up and I started realizing that I have a whole gamut of emotions, and now women have always had the luxury of being able to express themselves emotionally. If they're sad, they get to be sad. If they're angry, they get to be angry. Men only anger. I read somewhere years ago that whenever men have an emotion, that it turns to anger in like 0.2 seconds. And so for me personally in relationships, I really had to slow down and say, okay, wait a minute, what am I really feeling? And let me work on the appropriate response to that particular emotion. And I think women have always had the luxury. I think men, we still have that anger issue that we deal with. But in terms of, you know, the physical difference, the mental difference, I really want to take it off of the woman and the man. I really just want to put it on myself and say it's me who needed to grow in my relationships. I should say I've been married 27 years. Where's the clap? Well, thank you. I appreciate that. I probably should tell you it was the three different women, though, okay? I'm sorry.
So, well, I'm going to say the same thing that makes me different from you is the same thing that makes men and women different from each other. And that's why we have in this class now. I don't know. I can't. I'm asking the same question. That's why I showed up just like you.
Well, I have some thoughts on the differences between men and women. You know, the brain between male and female is very different. The male brain, it looks something like how can I say? So, men have very unique brains. We have boxes for everything. We have boxes for money, boxes for the job, boxes for sex, boxes for wives, boxes for ourselves, boxes for our exes. We have boxes for everything, right? And the rule is, the boxes do not touch. Right? So that means when we have a conversation, we'll find the box, right, about a particular thing. We'll find the box, we pull it out, we open it up, and we talk only about what's in the box. And when we're done, we close the box, we put it back so as not to touch any of the other boxes. So women's brains are completely different. They have brains that are just like a ball of wire where everything is connected to everything, right? And so that's why it's so easy for them to deflect and to talk about things that are, in our view, unrelated, but to them is related, and it affects, you know, how they feel about us and, you know, just I mean, that is really, in my view, a key difference in the way men and women think. So that's what
I think. I think the main difference between men and women is women tend to be more emotional. Women are very emotional. Men are very unemotional. And so women are more in touch with their feelings and they express their feelings, and men not so much. So I think that's where the biggest difference comes in terms of relationship and making a relationship work is women toning down and maybe men toning more up and being more involved with our emotions and expressing those emotions. So I think that's probably the biggest difference.
I tend to agree with everything these brothers have said up here tonight. There was a study done a few years ago that showed that women have the ability to hear and comprehend more than one conversation at a time. And men, we tend not to have that. Which is why when you're sitting, you see us watching the game, we are comprehending what's happening there. And then women want to come in and say, hey, by the way, you know, and that is not easy for us to adjust out of this one thing, like the brother said, out of this box and then go to the box that you want us to pull out and address. And so I think that's a major key difference between men and women.